While this style of music might be regarded somewhat cynically as a kind of opportunistic tourist nationalism, to quote a recent historian, listeners in Dvořák's time thought the very opposite, describing the dances as natural and perfect, with no trace of artificiality or restraint. "Divine providence flows through this music," wrote influential critic Louis Ehlert in the Berlin newspaper Nationalzeitung. Indeed, so successful were the Slavonic dances that not only did their sheet music sales skyrocket, the dances were soon being performed at concerts in Dresden, Hamburg, Berlin, Nice, London, and even New York. A hint of negativity, though, crept into the reception of Dvořák's music. Not that of his Slavonic dances, but rather his next large-scale offering, the more extended Slavonic rhapsodies. The composer began to notice that some in the specifically Viennese audience seemed to harbour an anti-Czech cultural bias. In a letter to conductor Hans Richter, Dvořák admitted, "In the Viennese papers yesterday, I read the programme of the Philharmonic concerts in Vienna. I am glad you have remembered my humble self again, but I have some misgivings about the choice of the Slavonic Rhapsody, because Viennese audiences seem to be prejudiced against a composition with a Slav favour, so it may not be as successful as it might in other circumstances. It went very well in London and Berlin, and will do well elsewhere too, but in the national and political conditions prevailing here, I am afraid it will not be well received." Dvořák's concern about this mounting cultural bias against the Czech people and their cultural artefacts was such that he wrote to Simrock requesting that the titles of his compositions be published in German and in Czech, that his vocal works were accompanied by texts in both languages, and that his forename was printed as simply Ant, an abbreviation of both the Czech Antonín and the German Anton. Some historians have also argued that this Viennese bias, a result of political tensions within the Austrian Empire, nudged Dvořák to develop a different musical language. The Slavonic aspect of his style was, in general, toned down, the overall impression much less jovial and festive. Instead, we hear music full of tension and drama, with stark contrasts in dynamic and melodies leaping frantically between high and low notes. Dvořák's F minor piano trio, composed in early 1883 following the death of the composer's mother in December 1882, provides a good example.